So why don't you tell us who you are and what you study, and then we can talk more about the experiments you do.
Sure. My name is Katie Milkman, and I am a professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania, and I do research on how to overcome follow-through problems that people suffer from. So how do we get people to go get flu shots and turn out to vote and follow through on their intentions to save more for retirement? All those kinds of big questions that we struggle with daily.
Nice. And do you want to tell us about the latest and greatest finding that you guys had?
Absolutely. So along with Todd Rogers, who's a professor at the Harvard Kennedy School, we were seeking solutions for how to get people to follow through at a higher rate. And he had this great idea, which was to co-opt distinct things in the environment, hijack them, if you will, and turn them into reminders. So for instance, imagine telling yourself that next time you see a Halloween parade, that's going to be a reminder to you to get a flu shot. Right time of year, something that you're not going to be able to overlook in the environment because it's very unusual. Or what if we actually strategically place these kinds of distinctive cues in the environment to help remind you so you'll follow through on things, like putting jugglers on university campuses and courtyards on election day and letting students know that when they see the juggler, they should remember to turn out to vote. So this research looks at whether or not that's a successful strategy for increasing follow through and finds that indeed it is. And that the more distinct the reminder that we imbue or co-opt and make into something that will trigger these memories, the more effective.
Nice. And what do you mean by distinct?
So we have this one study, actually, where we very specifically get at distinctiveness. And what we show is that if something in the environment is sort of commonplace, it's something that doesn't really stand out, it looks like all the other things you encounter, like your toothbrush or, you know, the traffic light you pass every Tuesday, it's not going to catch your attention. But if it's something quirky that you're not used to seeing, and so the name of our paper is actually Elephants and Aliens, things you're not used to seeing, if it really stands out from the everyday, like a Halloween parade, like a juggler in the courtyard, that's when it's going to be an effective reminder that if you can co-opt it, turn it into a reminder, there's no way you'll fail to notice. It's going to be in your face and hopefully will lead you to follow through at a higher rate.
Nice. So does this mean that our typical way to remind people, like emails, are not that effective?
Yeah, so there's a lot of research suggesting that on important follow-through failures, emails and text reminders and letters, they have benefits, but I think we can do better. So for instance, on Get Out the Vote, Todd has done a lot of research on this, suggesting that reminders just aren't that great. There's so much going on that it's really easy to easy to hit delete or miss it, or just to be too bleary-eyed to pay attention to yet another sign. But if we can have something that really jumps out at you, that may be even more effective.
Nice. And one of the cool things that they did was they put something at the cash register when they wanted you to use a coupon. So do you want to talk about the timing of the reminder as well?
Absolutely. So there's research suggesting that the timeliness of a reminder is absolutely critical to its effectiveness. Mm-hmm. So one of my favorite studies on this is a study looking at trying to remind people to actually buckle up as they're driving away from a hotel. And it might have been a restaurant, as they're driving away from a valet stand. So they have valets who are reminding people to buckle up, and they randomly assign the valets to either give no reminder, give a reminder right as they run off to grab your car, so like 2 minutes before you get in, or give you the reminder as you're getting into your car. And it's actually only effective if it's literally as you're stepping into the vehicle. So the timeliness is really a critical element to a reminder's effectiveness. And what's tricky is that it's hard to time reminders perfectly, right? If you're trying to design technology to text reminder people at exactly the right moment, or to send them an email, they may not open it at the right moment. All those things can fail. But this idea of co-opting this distinctive can be really effective if we can place those distinctive cues in exactly the moment when someone needs to remember. So for instance, we have this study at a coffee shop where we tell people, remember to use your coupon, which is going to expire soon, but remember to use your coupon on the day when it's going to be viable, because there's going to be a little alien figurine sitting on the counter right in front of the cash register. And if we tell you that, that's more effective than if we just say, remember when you see the cash register to use this coupon. Even if the alien's there in both situations, it means something special, it's distinctive, and it serves as a reminder once we've primed it as such.
Nice. So last question, how have you used reminders in your personal life? Any creative advice that you've taken to heart?
Yeah, I do try whenever, especially Todd and I were talking about this as academics, like we are always thinking about our work and things we need to do, and a lot of the times, right at the end of a long day, you're sort of lying in bed, awake, trying to fall asleep and remember something you need to do.
Yeah.
And one of the things that's cool about cues is you can use them as self-reminders. So an organization can insert a cue and try to remind you, but you can do it for yourself too. So when you don't have the technology, or the technology, your to-do list is so long it doesn't matter anymore, you're lying awake at night trying to think, how will I remember to do this tomorrow? You can use these kinds of cues. Think, what distinctive is going to happen to me tomorrow? And try to actually build in that trigger. Say, when I see my student at 10:30 a.m., who I'm meeting with for the first time ever, she's a new student, I'll remember to do this. Or when I see this other distinct thing that I anticipate maybe in my environment tomorrow, I'll remember to do this. So you can do it to yourself, and I do it a lot as I'm trying to remember things on my to-do list.
Nice. Thank you very much. This is very great. And we'll remember to continue to follow you.
Thanks for
having me. When I see Katie, I will remember to follow her.
Excellent.